So what about these trains then? So we had this, we saw that the shops had a lot of concurrency. We also saw that our scores, we could have these different teachers who did their job individually, and then we kind of coordinated that role through the class teacher. So here, how can we think of?
Here is natural concurrent. Train is running concurrent.
Yeah, we already saw that actually the same train actually runs on many days.
You know,
so we have to be able to ask at a given time,
where are you?
Where are you? And it depends on which.
So the train is all. All the trains are running. I mean, some of course, the train has to be created. The object has to be created from the class. But once created, it's running.
Okay. So at a given time, for each train,
multiple trains will be running.
Yeah. So if I fix the day of the week and the time, and all trains are running on time, for example, then some of these trains are running
at any given point in time. I can check
ask who's running. Yeah. And
where you are.
I mean,
where you are. Like
I
that,
can
yeah.
kind of get. So that will be the snapshot of all the
trains running.
Trains running.
If you have a map, you can see, you know, the train will be sitting somewhere on the map. And some stations also, some trains will be actually sitting in the stations.
Yeah, so some of them will be waiting,
To cross the station, which trains are waiting in the station? Are there any trains sitting in the station right now? Some stations will have, some stations will not have.
Yeah.
Some stations will have more than one also.
Correct.
Right?
Multiple platforms and...
And also sometimes junction and all, they stay there for a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, because even here you can see, typically, I mean, here some of these trains, like it stops in Kharagpur for 5 minutes. Okay. So here also you can see that this one, this first train at Adra stops for 10 minutes. So different, depending on the train and its schedule, it could
be sitting in the station.
Sitting for 7 minutes.
So you can ask the stations, how many trains are sitting here with you right now?
Right.
So there's a lot of concurrency here. All the stations are concurrently doing something. Trains are running.
Yeah.
Are they interacting?
Hardly
any, yeah?
Not much, right? I guess
stations
except for
trains will interact.
Stations and train will interact to the extent that
train will enter the station.
Yeah, so that means the station is now occupied. So the next train has
to wait.
Wait in case there is, I mean normally it will be scheduled so that they don't have to wait. But if there's a delay or something, then you know that the next train has to wait for the first train to go past. So it'll have to, check with the.
So what will it do? Second, so another train. So the train is coming to a station.
Yeah. So it'll have to ask the station,
"Are you free?
Are you free?" And that
station
will look at its timetable, maybe like this, and it'll look at the previous train on that day and that thing and see whether it has left. So it'll ask that train, "Where are you?"
Train, "I'm with you only. I'm sitting inside station." Okay. Then he'll say, "All right."
Then I'll go back into the guy and say, "No, you have to wait.
You have to wait." So that guy will, usually he will park outside the station. No? They'll be waiting outside the station.
Yeah.
So they're interacting because trains are delayed and therefore
the
station gets occupied.
Yeah.
And so it makes this train get delayed. But then there may be another train coming on the track. No?
Correct. So that guy will also get delayed, I suppose. So because now he'll ask the station, the station will
usually the guy will, how does it work?
So there have to be signals. No?
There are signals. Okay.
Yeah. So somebody has to set a signal. So the station will have to send the instruction saying, "Now I have one train waiting, so put a red light before that," or something. You know?
Like that they do. So that means the other train will be waiting somewhere else,
yeah, it has
far
to
away.
Be, yeah, as you said, otherwise it will...
It will crash.
Yeah, it doesn't,
train.
It does this train. Station is not free, but it doesn't know how many trains are there in
height. Crazy stuff. So basically, so the trains are interacting with each other primarily because they share some resource. Which resource is this? Now it says station.
Says the station.
Or track.
The track, yeah.
They're all traveling on the same track, so they're sharing resources. So if the resource is occupied, like the shop. One customer is occupying the resource shop.
So the
other
guys
wait.
Wait in the
queue.
So they have a queue of trains here waiting.
You have a queue of trains waiting in the, waiting to get a track or a station or whatever it is.
And then, so here the train is talking to the station.
Okay.
But you might, so sometimes we saw that there are some very important places where people might change trains, right? Delhi or Calcutta or something like that. So supposing a lot of people are coming from one direction and they are expecting to get into a train to go somewhere else. And this train is getting delayed for whatever reason.
There is commuter trains.
Yeah.
There is a train which goes from, say, Delhi to a nearby place. And there is a big train that is coming from, let us say, Chennai to Delhi. So usually a lot of people get out from this Chennai Delhi train and then they get into a commuter train and go to some nearby city.
So then there's no point if that train takes off before this train.
That'll be empty and then all these people have no
and
train.
They'll all be stuck.
Usually so, delay that also. That's what happens.
Yeah. So then this train will have to somehow have to tell that train to wait.
Oh, I see. So this train will have to via station or?
Well, if it knows, so if there is some information that we have about which trains are.
You'll tell the station.
Yeah, we can tell the station. I'm delayed. So the station,
will decide.
Yeah, it will look at trains which are leaving after this train arrives.
And which are dependent on it in some sense. And a lot of passengers move from one to another.
And if it knows about this information.
From its history, it knows that.
Yeah. It will then tell signal to them that maybe you should
wait.
Postpone your departure.
By 10, 20 minutes.
Yeah, something like that.
If it is too long, then you may say, forget it, go.
Because there may be another train.
There may be another train later on.
Yeah, so that's.
So things which are getting delayed may cause delay in connecting trains and all that. So there's a lot of interaction like that may happen.
Yeah. So between trains and stations, you could have this indirectly a train telling another train to wait.
Okay. I want to go back to one of the earlier problems that we did. This is.
Yeah. We can do that. How to get from one station to another.
Okay. So there is two stations are there, but there may not be a direct train.
Yeah. So direct train is relatively easy. I am a station. I ask you to tell me the list of trains that you have, or I send you the list of trains that I pass through, and we check whether there is a train in common.
So that is easy. That's easy. So we don't want to do direct train. So assume that we are trying to find a way via a junction.
One stop. So
there are two objects here. There's station one is one object. Station two is the other object.
And each has a list of trains that pass through. Right? I have trains which pass through me.
And I have.
You have trains which pass through yours. You are a station. You have trains. And we need to know whether these trains somehow intersect.
Which means that the trains
They have a common station on their route. So I have for every train in my set, and for every train
in your. Can some nice concurrent way of doing this? I mean,
What do we want to do? We want to ask a train to compare its stations with another train, right?
We have stations. Let's start with stations.
So I have station one. Mm-hmm. Right. So if I look at my card, for instance, okay, I get a list of
train objects. I know the train objects.
Yeah. So a list of trains one, I will say.
Okay.
Similarly,
which I have to create. I mean, may if not be the objects I have to create.
Yeah, you have to create them and so on. Similarly, station 2 will have that.
We'll have a list of train objects. These are two objects, two station objects have their own lists of train objects.
Correct.
So we have two lists of objects.
So this is, so if we draw it as a thing, so it is some list of trains.
Trains.
Okay. And this has a
another list of trains.
Maybe a smaller list of trains.
Okay.
So now what I will do is I will say it doesn't matter which. So station 1 asks station 2 for its list of trains.
That's the first step. Mm. Okay. Right.
So you ask for.
Station 1 object will request, send a message to station 2 object saying, give me your list of trains. Yeah?
Yeah.
This is get rid of this.
Yeah, so now this comes.
This comes and sits here.
Yeah, so it will have its tray as usual.
Okay.
So you'll have this tray into which you will put this.
This guy puts the result.
These three trains from there.
Okay. So now both the lists are inside this.
So now station 1 can start do the job.
It has both the lists, both the lists of objects.
Yeah, it has its own train objects and it has all the train objects of station.
Foreign object, okay.
So now what it needs to do is, we said, for each of these, it has to compare with each of these.
What does it have to compare?
It has to check whether the list of stations for train in the first train overlaps with the list of stations here. Wherever there is a common station, that is a possible junction.
So this is, each of these is an object, no? Each box which you have drawn is an object. This also is an object.
Yeah.
So this object and this object have to talk to each other.
Yeah. And then this object has to talk to that also, and this object has to talk to it. So what it can do, so what we can do is we can tell the station object to pass this whole thing to this guy. So let's give them some names. So let's call this T1, T2, T3, T4, and T5 and T6. So there are six trains which belong to the first station. Okay, and let's call this, I don't know, U1, U2, U3. There are these three trains which belong to the second guy. So now what this station 1 is going to do is, it is going to take this T1 object, right, and is going to pass it this U1, U2, U3, saying compare yourself with these three guys.
Okay. Right? All right.
And then it's going to do the same
you
thing.
You can pass it one at a time also. You can give it U1, just give it U1, U2.
Yeah, I can do it one at a time also.
Or you can just give U1 station actually. I also you can.
Yeah. But this is nice.
This is nicer.
Because then we just, it's like our earlier
modular,
thing, right?
Much more
so
modern.
You can pass it to T1 and then let T1 do its
let
job.
Let T1 do
meanwhile
it.
You call T2 and say T2 you.
Oh, parallel.
So these are all independent jobs.
Okay, okay.
Right? So what this will now do is, it will come back.
So T1, what will do?
So T1 will first check its station list with the U1 station list.
Okay.
So each train object has a list of stations, right? So it will come back with some J1.
For which again it will have to talk. T1 has to talk T1.
T1 will talk to itself.
U1 object is there, but
yeah.
So T1 has to consult U1 object and
yeah, it has to ask U1 object
for its stations.
Its stations and so on, right?
So T1 object will ask U1 object for its stations.
Yeah, and
then it will compare those stations with its own stations.
And you will get some list of junctions.
List of junctions.
Right? And same with J2 and J3. So it will produce three lists of junctions. These may be empty.
Okay.
Since that there is no junction. Okay.
And similarly, then, T2 will do this.
Yes, T2 will do the same thing. So it will come out with some JJ1, JJ2. Right? So this way each.
You get every train basically produces a list of junctions.
Yeah. And then from this, now these will all go back to station 1 because station 1 has asked them to do this. So station 1 will get three lists from the first guy, three lists from the second guy, three lists from the third guy. And whichever ones are not empty,
it can assemble all of them.
It tells the station 1 that for any non-empty list, it can say for this train, say from T4, I can connect on JJ something to U3 and then get to station 2.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. But the thing is that this searching here
is parallel.
It's all done concurrently. So T1 can process its neighbors independent of T2, independent of T3, and then all the answers come back.
So station 1 took its list of trains. From station 2, it got the station 2's list of trains.
Yeah. So that's like a standard remote procedure call.
Remote procedure call.
So it has to wait for that to come before it can't do anything without that.
After that, everything is inside station 1 now.
Yeah.
It took its list of stations that it got from the other guy and he passed those objects to.
Yeah. It takes that thing and passes it to each of its own
trains. Each of its own trains and tells the train,
you figure out and tell me if there's a good junction.
That guy will do a number of things. He will take his stations.
Yeah.
He will ask the objects
for that guy's station.
For those guy's stations. He will take those stations. He will compare the stations. And find out the junctions, common junctions, if there are any.
Yeah.
If no junctions, then it will be empty. It will be. So he'll make such a list of possible junctions, right?
Yeah.
And then he will send these list possible junctions back to the parent.
Yeah.
Parent will assemble all this
information, and it will have information of the type. Start with some
train T1, let us say.
Transfer at some junction.
Go to junction J1. Go to U1.
U1, and then you will reach station.
You will reach station. Like that, he'll make the list.
Yeah.
So this is a concurrent way of doing it.
Yeah, concurrent way of doing
this. Concurrent way of doing this.
Yeah, so instead of doing it one by one, you can speed up things this way.
Speed up things this way.
Yeah.